thanks for joining us on the Boxing Trade Show podcast. I'm Chris Maylett, joined by Aki Karim. And Aki, we've got a special guest on today, one of our favourite lads on the circuit. It's Liverpool's finest former world title challenger, Jazza Dickens. Jazz, first of all, mate, it's great to have you with us here on the show.
Thank you. Thank you for having me on, Chris. That was a perfect introduction, if I do say so myself, and I can't believe you've never practiced it before.
Got it in one take. Yeah. Thank you, Jazza. We were talking about it, Aki, earlier on. We want to fight. This is Ryan Walsh. Two real honest lads, aren't they? I've seen some of the things you've done. There's no animosity there. But, Aki, we have got some fighting prospects here, haven't we?
Oh, this is a great fight. You know, it's a great final. Whoever wins will be completely deserved of the golden contract title. Ryan Walsh, he's no mug, is he? I mean, he's had 8 British title fights, 30 fights in all. He's a really experienced campaigner. And Jazza, we know what Jazza can do. I'd love to talk about Jazza, the semi-final fight as well, before we move on to the final fight. I mean, a lot of people wrote you off against Lee Wood. And you said in your post-fight interview that you said to the crowd, a lot of you wrote me off.
Yes.
So how did it feel, to sort of prove doubters wrong and put in such a great performance?
It was some fight, that.
Yeah, I was confident all the time. I was confident whoever was going to fight, even going into the fight. I actually felt like, and I believed, and I still believe that, no one in the tournament wanted to pick me or they would have, or no one in the tournament wanted me at any point. So I said at the time, I'm going to fight the best in the tournament at some stage or another. And whoever, I did know it, I'd be fighting Lee Woods and I'd be fighting Ryan Walsh unless they fought each other.
You know, when you look at Ryan, what are you expecting on the night from him? I mean, you can look at what he's done and, but on the night, on this fight, it's the final. Everything else goes out of the window. It's just used to there in that final. What are you expecting from Ryan?
I'm expecting the best version of him that he's ever been, because I think that he has to be, and I have to be. I think for what's on the line, we both have to be at the best that we've ever been. And I can't see it not being nothing but a brilliant fight, But I can hear a teaspoon in the background there. Is someone drinking tea? And if so, I hope it's Yorkshire tea.
It's not me. I think it might be Chris.
Definitely not me.
Oh, you know what it is? My wife's actually getting the baby packed up to take her out. It may be something to do with the car seat.
I agree
with you, Jazza. Yorkshire tea.
I've got a feeling that you're drinking PG tips and you're just embarrassed here.
No, Jazza, I was born in Sheffield, mate. So if I'm going to drink a brew, it's going to be Yorkshire tea all day, every day.
Jazza makes a good brew. I've had one at his.
He's also got some ducks in his back garden.
Yeah.
I tell you, he's dead, didn't I tell you?
Oh, no.
The duck's dead, man.
Oh, you know what?
No,
that's
no.
The fox bit its head off, right? And it didn't even just bit its head off and left. Shouldn't you have? Just bit its head off for fun.
I wish I'd mentioned that now. We're gonna get people ringing in saying we're kicking off against the ducks.
Well, that's it's nature, isn't it? Nature, but there's a bit of a training partner for you as well, Jazza. So that's not help camp.
Could have been a fox. Could have been Aki. No one ever seen the killer.
Not Ryan Walsh, was it?
Yeah.
You're with Derry Matthews now over there, and George Yvonne at the Derry Matthews gym there. You was also doing the stuff with is it John the university?
Carl Evans.
Strength and conditioning.
Carl Evans, sports scientist from John Moores University. I'm still with Carl Evans, yeah.
What are the benefits of that? What have you seen now? So obviously, you've been with him for quite a while now. What has that brought to you as a boxer?
Yeah, well, I think the evidence of it is that, like, when I went and met Georgie Vaughan and Derry Matthews, my career just took off. It changed massively, didn't it? And alongside meeting Georgie and Derry, I also met Carl at the same time. So we've always done the camps together. We've had 7 fights together, and every one of them, Carl's been involved as well with the strength and conditioning and nutrition side of it. So he's changed my career too massively. I'm still working with Carl. Carl's a massive part of my team, and I'm very grateful to Carl. Just the knowledge that he's got, and the way he is, he was a fighter himself. He went to Junior Olympics at Taekwondo, and he specializes in weight making performance. He doesn't say that fighters shouldn't make weight. He says fighters are gonna make weight. So what we should do, we should know the best way to do it and the healthiest way and the safest way. And that's what he's got a PhD in, stuff like that. And he works in the fifth largest university. He's the head of sports science in the fifth largest university in the world. So to have him in my corner is a blessing. So I've got a really, really good team around me, as well as Tony Bellew and MTK too. So I'm really lucky, really, really lucky. Sometimes I pinch myself and think, bloody hell, I've landed on my feet here.
Well, you're very popular within the boxing trade though, Jazza, aren't you? You know, and that's the thing, you know, when you talk to other fighters, they've got a lot of respect for you. You've sparred a lot of the lads on in the Northwest and further afield as well. So, you know, what's it like to have a really good, solid backing within the trade as well?
It's nice, you know, Ak. It's nice because, as you both know, the people in the boxing community are some of the best people in the world. It doesn't matter where you're from, what background you're from. If you're a good person, you're a nice person, you're well-liked, you get on in boxing. You get on with these people because it's just full of good people. It's full of good opportunities. And I think it's good to know people in boxing and to also put yourself out there and get to know and try and make friends in this community, because it's an amazing community. It's a hard-working community. So I just feel blessed sometimes to know these people and to speak to these people and get knowledge and advice from these people. I always ask. Only last week I was in Jamie Moore's gym and I was asking Jamie about the back ends of his career and how it worked out for him, and just getting his advice. And I always try and get these people's advice, you know what I mean? If they like it, they'll tell you, won't they? If they don't, they just clam up. But getting on with the boxing community is a big thing for me, because I love boxing myself and I love to hear boxing stories as well. So yeah, I think we're very, very blessed to be in this, to have this type of community.
And how have you approached this particular fight then, Jazz? Obviously, Ryan Walsh is a very experienced guy himself. You know, he's got a lot of backing himself. And people are seeing this as a really good pick-em fight. You know, how have you as a team approached this camp and trying to work out how to strategize the fight and what approach to take?
Yeah, not too much emphasis on anything else, like, apart from what we normally do, because doing what we've done, it's got me here, do you know what I mean? I believe doing what we do, it's not broke, so don't fix it. But I also acknowledge that just because it's not broke, you don't have to improve. But we are improving in the gym. I am working on a better version of being myself, and that's how I'm approaching it, just being the better version of being myself. You know, I'm not too much emphasis on him, as I imagine is his emphasis, not too much on me.
What's your sparring been like for this, Jazza? Have you been travelling about, or have you had lads in the gym?
Been really good sparring. We started our sparring with Meshach Spear, a kid from Liverpool. You know Meshach, being on the shows, I think. Good sparring. He's always good sparring. Meshach, spar with Meshach. Went to spar with Brian Phillips. We sparred with an old really good kid called Tom H. He's a young fighter. I don't know if you'll know him yet, but you will do in the future. A really good fighter, Tom H. His name is. He trains at the Tonks gym with Dave and Joe Tonks, father and son. In Liverpool and speak, and then went on to spar with Akib Fiaz.
Yeah.
Good little boxer. He used to know him. The last 2 weeks I've been sparring with Luke Willis, and I've been sparring with Tom Farrell and John O'Carroll. So yeah, things are going really, really, really well. And me training on the hills, is a massive part of my programme, my fitness. I'm lucky to have everything on my doorstep. I've got Carl Evans, been doing my strength conditioning with him, and I've been doing my boxing, you know, my pads and my bags, and with Jerry and Georgie in the gym.
So, yeah. You mentioned there, Jazza, there. It was a good variety of sparring partners there, as you mentioned, Southpaw and Orthodox. You also, though, met, you know, those names, some of them were pressure fighters, some of them were good movers, you know, some of them were slicksters. You know, so are you expecting to have a sort of a fight on your hands against Walsh, where you're going to have to adapt on the night? Are you trying to get as many versatile styles in as possible so you can accommodate plans A, B and C on the night?
Yeah, well, that's how you sort of work. Like, when you look at a sparring, you're not going to get no one like who can replicate them perfectly, unless it was to phone their kid and say, do you want to go?
Yeah.
One of his brothers. But yeah, you're not going to get someone. So you have to pick things from each fighter's. And good fighters can adapt, and they can change the style mid-fight, mid-round, you know what I mean, mid-minute. They can change the fight anytime they want, really, and they can go back to what they're not doing so good, and they can go back to things that they need to... They can stop working, they can work more. So Yeah, just the emphasis has been on getting a lot of variety. Southpaw, Orthodox, small people, slick people, accurate fighters, balanced, composed, which Ryan Walsh is. So I've been working on a lot of things like that, yeah. So it is going well.
In terms of the actual golden contract, the winner, there's a lot of spoils for the winner by the sounds of it. How much of a boost will it give you to actually win the tournament? You know, what would it mean to you? And also, what doors do you think it will open for you?
Well, to me, it means that I can keep on fighting, I can keep on progressing, and I will get to the world title. That's what it means for me. But for my family, it means that life will change and life will be nice. And, you know, not much will change in the way of, like, who we are and what we stand for. But I think that maybe security, you have kids and you realise...
Yeah.
Financial security is an important thing, isn't it? And it's nice for you to look at your kids and say, you don't have to worry at night, knowing your kids are asleep and you're looking at them back and you're thinking, I need to make it happen for you, I need to provide for you, and that financial security, it's a nice thing, and I believe I deserve. Yeah. And that will be nice, not just for my kids, but for my partner. Actually, stuck by me for all these years, and there's times when I'm saying to her, have you got fucking £2 so I can go to the gym, do you know what I mean? I can be struggling, and it'll be nice for them after I can provide for them, you know.
So it is a great fight. It's a great fight. We're really looking forward to it. You deserve everything that's coming your way, Jazz. You deserve everything where you are. You know, you're a good guy and you've paid your dues in the game. God bless you in this fight. We've got to be neutral in it. You know how much we think of you, but it's a great fight for the fans, domestic fight, and we're all looking forward to it. Wish you all the best, mate.
Thank you so, lads. Thank you so much, lads, for having me on. Appreciate it and appreciate your time as always. And you both do a great job within the boxing community. And without the likes of you lads, then we wouldn't be thriving the way we are. So thank you to you as well, lads.
It's great to speak to you, Jazz.
Have a nice night, boys.
It seemed to go all right, didn't it? So
it seemed to go all right, yeah. Until we asked him about the duck.
the poor duck, yeah.
Poor duck. I know, look, honestly, I love animals and I love ducks.
I met the duck when I went down. I can't believe I've been invited to the funeral.
I know, mate, yeah. It's one of them. But it was great chatting to you and Jazza, as always.
Yeah, well, thanks for tuning in to the Boxing Trade Show podcast for another episode. We'll catch you again soon.